Hey everyone, want to show you signal flow for Studio B for your vocal recording session. You can see I've got the baby bottle set up here with the vocal isolation booth. I also have some headphones set up. Those are plugged into the inputs on the wall. We have 16 inputs. Simply enough, the baby bottle's plugged into input one and the headphones are plugged into A. You could put the headphones in any one of those inputs. Let's go ahead and head to the studio here. All right, I'll shut the door behind me. So you can see I've got Pro Tools hanging out here, already set up. So let's go ahead and get signal flow from that microphone. It's coming into input one. So because it's a baby bottle condenser mic, we want to make sure we have phantom power turned on and then some preamp. You do have to turn up the input fader, and in this case, the long throw faders are acting as our input fader. We then assign this channel to any one of the 8 buses on the Toft console. These 8 buses feed the 8 bus output faders, which then leave the console into the 8 analog inputs of this 828 audio interface. So what we would do on channel 1 here is choose the 1-2 switch and then pan all the way to the left, so we're just sending it to bus 1. We go to the bus 1 output fader, that then sends the audio out of the console into analog 1 of that 828 interface. We then go into Pro Tools. You can see in Pro Tools I have my first track is my stereo background track, and then I have multiple vocal tracks ready to go. So I would go to this first vocal track and assign the input. When you go to the input, you're going to see interface and you're going to have a ton of options. You want to choose analog 1. You do not want to choose the first two options, mic instrument 1 or mic instrument 2. Those two options are the preamps hanging out on the front of the mode 2 interface. So instead, we just want to choose this analog 1. We arm the track and we should see a little bit of level. Yeah, no one's out there talking, but we have a little bit of level in Pro Tools. Now, if we want to hear Pro Tools, we go to the top right-hand corner of the Toft console, you're going to find the switching bank. And the bottom option is labeled Pro Tools, 2-track, 2-return. We need to make sure that that is selected. And then you have your monitor level hanging out right here. That's going to be your volume of any track coming out of Pro Tools. Notice that down here in Studio B, all of my outputs are set to main out 1 and 2, which is an option down there in that list there. There we are. Now if you wanted to send to the headphones, we're going to go to that vocal track and go to the send section. Send A, we'll choose output, analog, 7 and 8. When I choose that option, what that's saying is that this 828, the analog 7 and 8, is connected to this Presonus headphone amp hanging out over here. So if I go to analog 7 and 8, it'll call up a fader. I can choose pre to make it pre-monitor fader and then adjust the volume. That's going to be the volume of just that track. So you would want to assign every single one of these tracks to analog 7 and 8 so you can feed them to this headphone amp. The last thing on the headphone amp that you want to do is take a look at this note here. It says Mix A Toft, Mix B Pro Tools. You'll recall we have this mix knob, A and B. We want to make sure that when we're using Pro Tools and using that output analog 7 and 8, that we have these over on the Mix B side. So on every channel, I've already set Mix B to be the mix for Pro Tools. Then you can see here, channel 1, that would be the A input out in the studio. 2 is B, C, and D. You just verify that your master volumes are up, that your individual volumes are up, and they will be able to hear headphones. So that's signal flow for Studio B to prep you for your vocal recording session.